Some cherry tomatoes, please, yeah?
Cooking is Euten Lindsay's greatest passion. But earlier this year, the Jamaican-born chef faced not only having to give up on his lifelong dream, but also deportation from the UK, where he has lived for 45 years.
I was told that I didn't exist, so I was this alien being that didn't have any rights and was treated so. It was very troubling for me because the threats by the Home Office in regards to my status, I had to sign on at the police station each week. I went there with the idea that I might not even come back out.
Euten's mother was part of the Windrush generation, a term given to Commonwealth citizens who came to the UK between 1948 and 1971. By the time 9-year-old Euten arrived in 1973, the rules had changed. 4 decades later, with no British passport and unable to prove he was here legally, Euten's life was thrown into turmoil. After months of worry, unable to work, claim benefits or access healthcare, the Home Office eventually decided Euten could stay for good.
I was so elated. I belong here. I can live here. I have a choice to go when I choose and when to come back. My world has been turned upside down through all of this, and I'm hoping that the government will show some sort of empathy and understanding of what an individual like me went through.
In a statement, the Home Office said it is a priority to right the wrongs that have been experienced by people who have built their lives here in the UK and contributed so much to our society. We have launched a dedicated task force for members of the Windrush generation and other long-term residents to make it easier for individuals to access support.
Well, the government is also considering awarding compensation to people like Euten, and they've promised to learn the lessons so that nothing like this can ever happen again.
With his new mobile food van up and running on Plymouth's picturesque Barbican, Euten's infectious positivity is even rubbing off on his staff.
I think it's absolutely great, to be honest. Always makes you feel happy when you're around him, and always knows how to cheer you up when you feel down. You see his passion in his food, and oh, he's just so good at what he does, really.
I came here as a child, and it wasn't to be a negative person. Our society has grown a bit insular and selfish. We should really reach out and not just think of oneself, but think of everybody. We are, after all, the human race.